At the end of the previous step, you'll have reformatted your table so it looks something like this. So check out that your data is in this format. Here, we're using data from the experiment that you are replicating, which was published in a paper called Antisocial Punishment Across Societies. So your numbers are going to be slightly different. Make sure you have clear headers for all the columns of your data. That's going to be important in a minute. Looking at this table, it's impossible to say what all these numbers mean, so we're going to plot all this data on a line chart. First, select the data you want to plot, including the headers. Click the Insert tab, the chart icon, and the line chart. It's the first one you see. Excel recognizes the headers and it plots each row separately. Now this chart looks great, but it's the wrong way around. We need to switch the axes. So right-click anywhere on the chart and a box pops up. Click on Select Data. Now click on the big button called Switch Row Column and click OK. As you can see, the coloured lines now all have names because they correspond to the columns rather than the rows. That's the way we want to display the data. You can also make this chart easier to read. One way to do this would be to move the legend to the side. Double-click on the legend, and under the Legend Options box that pops up, select Write. This is often easier to read, as if you're looking at the chart, you don't have to keep looking up and down to see which line is which. Click on Design. Click on Chart Element. You'll need to click on Primary Horizontal, then label it, and do the same for Primary Vertical. Finally, click on the chart title and give it a full title so that you and anyone else can understand what the data is and where it came from.